Good morning, school, and I hope this finds you well. I'm here today with my friend Gordon here because I wanted to talk to you a little bit about cooking and about the culinary world. You see, I'll be honest, I was a little bit bored. Lockdown gets me down, can't really go out, can't really do what you want to do. So I thought I needed to do something a bit different. So I challenged two of my colleagues. I spoke to Mrs. Marland and Mr. Harrow and said, right, let's have a bit of a cooking competition. What I'm going to do, I challenge them to cook something. Could be a meal, could be bread, could be cakes, could be anything. Anything they like. I said, look, what we're going to do is let's each of us cook a dish. Let's kind of record it, take a photo of it. And then we'll ask the students to rate our plate, to pick a winner. So what we're going to do is I'm going to show you a video clip of the three of us each cooking something. And then we're going to talk about how you can help pick a winner. Now, obviously, you can vote for anyone. You can vote for anyone you like. You could vote for Mrs. Marlin. You could vote for Mr. Harrow. Or you could vote for me if that's something that you wanted to do. So what we're going to do is we're going to see some video clips, and let's see what we can produce. We're going to do a very quick, very easy meal. It's lamb skewers, kind of Greek marinated lamb skewers. So all I'm going to do to start with is a little bit of a marinade for the lamb. This is obviously a meal that you really should have in a kind of sunny hillside in Kefalonia rather than a work weekend in Lancashire, but there we go, we'll give it a try. Now your marinade is super simple. Simply natural yogurt, mint, lemon, bit of paprika, and mix it all together and put it over the lamb. Cannot be any easier. All we've done is put it all together, lob the marinade on the lamb, stick it in the fridge. Ideally you marinate it overnight, but I wasn't organised enough, so we'll stick it in the fridge for a couple of hours and see what happens. Okay, so the next bit is really, really easy. Having marinated the lamb, all you do is you take it out, chop yourself a courgette, an onion, mushroom, whatever you got, peppers, whatever you got lying around in the fridge, and stick it all together onto skewers. Once you've done that, you should end up with something that looks a wee bit like that. Now, to be honest, the best way to cook this would obviously be outside on a barbecue, but it's freezing outside, so in truth, you can griddle them, or you can do what I do, which is I'm going to stick them under the grill. So let's do that and see how they come out. Once you've grilled them, sling them, serve them either with rice or pita bread and a bit of salad, a bit of garlic mayo or tzatziki, and wallop, you're good to go.
Making what, Harry?
Building a house. I don't like that one. I'm going to do another one.
Everything
looked up in that cookbook.
Everything looks what, Harry?
York.
York?
In that cookbook. And I'm building a house. No more.
How many sausages are in there, Harry?
No more.
How many sausages have you got?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Yay! There you go, Harry. Well done. Perfect. Oh, well done, Harry. Make sure it's all out. Let's do it together. Shake, shake, shake. Poured those eggs in, Harry. Keep going. And stop, stop. And then stop, stop. That's it, good girl. Well done. Let it keep going round. Pour a bit more in. That's it.
Yes.
In a minute, yes. Hang on, it's okay. Don't worry, it's okay.
No.
Keep pouring in, Harry. Can you do it? That's it. Well done. All of it in.
Oh.
Well done, Harry.
Look.
Oh. What's happening now, Harry?
Chocolate.
Making toad in the hole, aren't we?
Making toad.
don't want sausage and mash, Harry. Toad in the hole. No. Was it not good enough?
So I've seen enough Bake Off to know that the people who overcomplicate things often get into trouble. And whilst I'm sure that Mr Hayden will probably push the boat out with a marzipan rendering of the green sports hall or a sponge sugar replica of Mr McEwen's head, I've stuck with something simple that you can actually make and that's nice to eat. So these are cantuccini, which are Italian biscuits. And the recipe is courtesy of Italian cook and well-known restaurateur and also winner of I'm a Celebrity, Gino De Campo. So here it is. So we have 250 grams of flour. You put in 150 grams of caster sugar, then a teaspoon of baking powder. We put in two large eggs. We add in the zest of an orange. We put in a teaspoon of vanilla extract, 90 grams of pistachios and almonds. Smudge it all together. And then we divide the dough up into three equal pieces. And we make each of those into a flat loaf. We pop that in the oven, 180 degrees for 20 minutes. And then we take it out again and we slice it up into biscuits. And then we put it back in the oven for a few more minutes, get it out to cool. And then we serve that with a nice cappuccino.
Okay, so you've now seen all three dishes. You've seen my lamb skewers, Mrs. Marlon and Harriet with their toad in the hole, and the headmaster's biscuits. But we want your feedback. We it's a bit of a competition. We want to find out who you think is the best. So we've got a vote, and it's pretty easy to do. What I'd like you to do is to go to where you can either scan the QR code, which is in front of you, or go to menti.com, www.menti.com, and put in the code 1110830. That's 1110830. And then simply all you need to do is to decide whose plate you rate the highest. Is it mine? Is it Mrs. Marland or Mr. Harrow? So menti.com and the code 1110830. We really would like to see what you think. You know, the bragging rights are at stake. So do please do that and let us know. And after this, hopefully this might have inspired you. You know, we've got a bit of time on our hands. This might inspire you to cook something of your own. Cook a cake, make some bread, do a meal, cook for mum and dad, whoever. It would be great if you do that. And if you want, send me a picture of what you've done and we'll rate your plate. If it's brilliant, we'll praise you. If it's rubbish, we'll have a go at you. Fantastic. So please do have a vote, but then have a go. Why not get in the kitchen and cook something yourself? So have a great day, school, and we'll see you soon. Stay safe.